myself. This is place to move in. And for years I wanted to review End of Days. But I didn't get around to it in any of the Arnold Schwarzenegger months. Since there were other movies that I wanted to review instead. But now that I don't do months anymore dedicated to an actor, director or anything else, there's nothing steadying my way now. So today, I will be reviewing End of Days. You know, I was actually surprised by this. The movie is a lot better than I thought it would be. In fact, it is one of my favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. But more on that by the end of the video. So, yeah, without further ado, let's go. This movie is basically about a police detective who has to deal with some supernatural shit. Now first I'm going to talk about the main character of the movie, Jericho Kane, played by Arnold Schwarzenegger. Now, I was also surprised by how Arnold wasn't playing as a over-the-top badass like he usually does in his movies. In fact, in this movie, he plays as a pretty calm and a normal guy. And it's so fucking great to see that from Arnold. The fact that he manages to pull that off is a reason why I consider him my favorite actor of all time. And that is also the reason why this is one of my favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. But again, more on that by the end of the video. Now, he doesn't believe that any other supernatural shit is actually real, which is very logical and understandable. And yeah, that is the reason why I say that he is fucking normal in this movie. The second character that I want to talk about is his partner, Bobby Chicago, played by Kevin Pollak. Now, he's a good character, but there really isn't much to say about him. He doesn't really have a very memorable personality. He's just there as the partner of the protagonist. Of course, forgettable doesn't mean bad, and he is a good character, but pretty damn forgettable. And normally there is a third character to talk about, but honestly, the protagonist is the only one that sticks in my mind. That is, of course, not always a bad thing. If a movie has one great character and the rest of them are forgettable, it doesn't really matter to me. All that matters to me is if the main character is fucking great, which he is. Now then, what I really love about this movie is that it doesn't explain everything. There is a lot going on in the movie that's not explained at all. And you know what? That's a good thing. Because having something big in the movie and not explained properly makes it a mystery. And a mystery is a good thing for sure. A movie that is vague leads to more fucking discussions, which is a good thing. That makes the movie stick in my mind for a long time for sure. But the visuals are also fucking awesome. Now, don't get me wrong. A lot of it looks fucking ugly. And you know what? That's a good thing because it's supposed to look fucking ugly. I mean, it is evil after all, so that's not really a problem. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. This is definitely one of my favorite movies with Arnold Schwarzenegger. And for that, I'm gonna give this movie the rating 2 thumbs up. Oh, and while we are on the subject of best Arnold Schwarzenegger movies, I am willing to admit a mistake that I did in the past. Looking back, I shouldn't have made a top 5 favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movies and top 2 worst in the same video. I should have made a whole top 15 meteor signs. There are so many great movies out there with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Though, to be fair, I couldn't do that at the time, since back then, I hadn't watched many Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. So there wasn't enough to fill up a top 15 list. I mean, I have it now, but I didn't back then. But you know what I could have done instead? Fucking waited until after I have seen a shit ton of his movies and only make a list when I'm ready. And for those of you wondering, yes, that is the reason why I haven't made a top 15 favorite movies of the 1930s yet. But it will happen eventually, I promise. Just give it time. I will only make that video when I'm absolutely ready. Anyway, tell you what, if I get at least 15 comments on this video telling me that they want to see a countdown of top 15 favorite movies with Arnold Schwarzenegger, I will make a video like that before Halloween, I promise. But I only will if I get at least 15 comments on this video telling me that. And all within a week, aka 7 days. But if I don't get that many comments, I won't do it. But I will if I do, I promise. I highly fucking doubt I will get 15 comments telling me that they want to see a video like that. But I am sticking to my promise if I do. Still very unlikely to me. Anyway, you have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.